Hello, welcome to Just on Civil. Please subscribe for more videos. Today we will be learning about segregation and bleeding in concrete. Let's begin with segregation in concrete. Definition of segregation: separation of constituent materials in concrete. Constituent materials in concrete are cement, sand, coarse aggregate, and water. Types of segregation: separation of coarse aggregate from concrete mixture, separation of cement paste from concrete during its plastic stage, separation of water from concrete mix. This is also called bleeding. Primary cause of segregation: primary cause of segregation is difference in specific gravity of constituent. Different constituent of concrete have different specific gravity. For example, specific gravity of cement is 3.1 to 3.6 and that of aggregate is 2.6 to 2.7 and water is 1. Lighter particle tends to move upward, heavier particle tends to move downward due to specific gravity, and hence segregation occurs, that is separation occurs. Other causes of segregation are dropping concrete from more than 1 meter height, vibrating in vibrator, mechanical vibrator or others for very long time. Similarly, poorly proportioned mix may also cause segregation. How to minimize segregation? By proportioning the mix, by handling the concrete carefully, placing, transporting, compacting, and finishing. This process should be carried out carefully. Air entraining agents, admixtures, and pozzolanic materials can also be used to minimize segregation. This is a figure depicting segregation of concrete. Now, bleeding. Generally, it occurs in wet mix of concrete. It is also a form of segregation. Water present in concrete is pushed upward due to settlement of cement and aggregate, and bleeding occurs. Specific gravity of water is low, so it tends to move. Cause of bleeding: high water cement ratio. If water amount is more, that is water cement ratio is more, then bleeding occurs in concrete. Control of bleeding: air entraining admixtures can be used. Water cement ratio should be controlled, that is minimum amount of water. Bleeding is not harmful if the rate of evaporation is equal to the rate of bleeding. Normal bleeding is quite good and it enhances the workability, that is it makes the concrete workable. By enhancing the workability of concrete means the concrete can be placed, laid easily, friction is less, and there is not much problem in laying the concrete. This figure shows bleeding in concrete. You can see the water or cement paste at the surface of the concrete. This is how the concrete looks after it has bled. Thank you for watching. Please leave comment if you have any further questions. If you like the video, please subscribe, share,